The day these Afghan Air Force pilots got their wings, they also got a target on their head. At least 7 pilots have been murdered in recent months, hunted down by the Taliban as part of a campaign of revenge against anyone who worked with foreign forces. Naeem Asadi was one of the chosen few, trained by the US as an elite helicopter pilot. But when he was praised for helping to end an insurgent attack on Kabul, he and his family received death threats. He says he was granted a visa by the US, but the offer was withdrawn at the last minute. Lawyers believe the Afghan government stopped him from leaving, fearing it would damage morale. He's now in hiding. As the Taliban gain ground, the US has begun evacuating thousands of Afghans who've applied for special immigrant visas, or SIVs. The visas are available to Afghans who worked as translators or in other jobs for the US government. They're being flown to Fort Lee, a US military base in Virginia, for final processing. But thousands remain in limbo. This man has already had a visit from the Taliban.
My family hid me and told them Ramesh was gone somewhere, and I was hid inside the oven in my yard. Did it burn my house, and nothing remained to us.
The Taliban deny they're targeting interpreters, but this translator says she can't take the risk.
It's not easy to trust on Taliban. We cannot guarantee our lives with them. I cannot trust them.
With just weeks to go before the US mission formally ends, time is running out. But there's a catch-22. Those seeking a new life must have the extensive paperwork. But if the Taliban find such documents, it could be a death sentence.